Hello friends, welcome to NEET Wizard. Here audio notes for morphology of flowering plants. The wide range in the structure of higher plants will never fail to fascinate us. Even though the angiosperms show such a large diversity in external structure or morphology. They are all characterized by presence of roots, stems, leaves, flowers and fruits. We talked about classification of plants based on morphological and other characteristics. For any successful attempt at classification and at understanding any higher plant or for that matter any living organism, we need to know standard technical terms and standard definitions. We also need to know about the possible variations in different parts found as adaptations of the plants to their environment, for example, adaptation of to various habitats for protection, climbing, storage, etc. If you pull out any weed, you will see that all of them have roots, stems and leaves. They may be bearing flowers and fruits. The underground parts of the flowering plant is the root system, while the portion above the ground forms the shoot system. The root. In majority of dicotyledonous plants, the direct elongation of the radical leads to the formation of primary root, which grows inside the soil. It bears lateral roots of several orders that are referred to as secondary, tertiary, etc. roots. The primary roots and its branches constitute the tap root system, as seen in the mustard plant. In monocotyledonous plants, the primary root is short-lived and is replaced by a large number of roots. These roots originate from the base of the stem and constitute the fibrous root system, as seen in wheat plant. In some plants like grass, monstera and the banyan tree, roots arises from the parts of the plants other than the radical and are called adventitious roots. The main functions of the root system are absorption of water and minerals from the soil, providing a proper anchorage to the plant parts, storing reserve food material and synthesis of plant growth regulators. Regions of the root. The root is covered at the apex by a thimble-like structure called the root cap. It protects the tender apex of the root as it makes its way through the soil. A few millimeter above the root cap is the region of meristematic activity. The cells of these regions are very small, thin-walled and with dense protoplasm. They divide repeatedly. The cells proximal to this region undergo rapid elongation and enlargement and are responsible for the growth of the root in length. This region is called the region of elongation. The cells of the elongation zone gradually differentiate and mature. Hence, this zone proximal to region of elongation is called the regions of maturation. From this region, some of the epidermal cells form very fine and delicate thread-like structures called root hairs. These root hairs absorb water and minerals from the soil. Modifications of root. Roots in some plants change their shape and structure and become modified to perform functions other than absorption and conduction of water and minerals. They are modified for support, storage of food and respiration. Tap roots of carrot, turnips and adventitious roots of sweet potato get swollen and store food. Have you ever wondered what those hanging structures are that support a banyan tree? These are called prop roots. Similarly, the stem of maize and sugarcane have supporting roots coming out of the lower nodes of the stem. These are called stilt roots. In some plants, such as rhizophora, growing in swampy areas, many roots come out of the ground and grow vertically upwards. Such roots, called nematophores, help to get oxygen for respiration. The stem. What are the features that distinguish a stem from a root? The stem is the ascending part of the axis bearing branches, leaves, flowers and fruits. It develops from the plumule of the embryo of a germinating seed. The stem bears nodes and internodes. The region of the stem where leaves are borne are called nodes, while internodes are the portions between two nodes. The stem bears buds, which may be terminal or axillary. The stem is generally green when young and later often become woody and dark brown. The main function of the stem is spreading out branches bearing leaves, flowers and fruits. It conducts water, minerals and photosynthesis. Some stems perform the function of storage of food, support, protection and of vegetative propagation. Modifications of a stem. The stem may not always be typically like what they are expected to be. They are modified to perform different functions. Underground stems of potato, ginger, turmeric, jimikant, colocasia are modified to store food in them. They also act as organs of perination to tide over conditions unfavorable for growth. Stem tendrils, which developed from axillary buds are slender and spirally coiled and helps plants to climb, such as in gourds, cucumber, pumpkins, watermelon and grape pines. Axillary buds of a stem may also get modified into woody, straight and pointed thorns. Thorns are found in many plants such as citrus, bougainvillea. They protect plants from browsing animals. Some plants of arid regions modify their stems into flattened opuntia or flesh cylindrical euphorbia structures. They contain chlorophyll and carry out photosynthesis underground stems of some plants such as grass and strawberry, etc. Spread to Nunicias, and when older parts die, new plants are formed. In plants like mint and jasmine, a slender lateral branch arises from the base of the main axis, and after growing aerially for some time arch downwards to touch the ground. A lateral branch with short internode and each node bearing a rosette leaves and a tuft of roots is found in aquatic plants like Pistia and Icornia. In banana, pineapple and chrysanthemum, the lateral branches originate from the basal and underground portion of the main stem, grow horizontally beneath the soil and then come out obliquely upward, giving rise to leafy shoots. The leaf. The leaf is a lateral, generally flattened structure borne on the stem. It develops at the node and bears a bud in its axil. The axillary bud later develops into a branch. Leaves originate from shoot apical meristem and are arranged in an acropetal order. They are the most important vegetative organs for photosynthesis. A typical leaf consists of three main parts: leaf base, petiole, and lamina. The leaf is attached to the stem by the leaf base and may bear to laterally small leaf like structures called stipules. In monocotyledonous, the leaf base expands into a sheath covering the stem partially or wholly. In some leguminous plants, the leaf base may become swollen, which is called the pulvinus. The petiole help hold the blade to light. Long, thin, flexible petioles allow leaf blades to flutter in wind, thereby cooling the leaf and bringing fresh air to leaf surface. The lamina or the leaf blade is the green expanded part of the leaf with vein and winglets. There is usually a middle prominent vein which is known as the midrib. Veins provide rigidity to the leaf blade and act as channels of transport for water, minerals and food materials. The shape, margin, apex, surface and extent of incision of lamina varies in different leaves. Venation. The arrangement of veins and winglets in the lamina of leaf is termed as venation. When the winglets form a network, the venation is termed as the reticulate. When the veins run parallel to each other within the lamina, the venation is termed as parallel. Leaves of dicotyledonous plants generally possess reticulate venation, while parallel venation is the characteristics of most monocotyledonous. Types of leaves. A leaf is said to be simple when its lamina is entire or when incised. The incision do not touch the midrib. When the incision of the breaking it into a number of leaflets, the leaf is called compound. A bud is present in the axil of petiole in both simple and compound leaves, but not in the axil of leaflets of the compound leaf. The compound leaves may be of two types. In a pinnately compound leaf, a number of leaflets are present on a common axis, the rachis, which represents the midrib of the leaf, as in neem. In pometally compound leaves, the leaflets are attached at the common point, for example at the tip of petiole, as in silk cotton. Phyllotaxy. Phyllotaxy is the patterns of the arrangement of leaves on the stem or branch. This is usually of three types: alternate, opposite and whorled. In alternate type of phyllotaxy, a single leaf arises at each node in alternate manner, as in China rose, mustard and flower plants. In opposite type, a pair of leaves arise at each node and its opposite to each other, as in calotropis and guava plants. If more than two leaves arise at the node and form a whorl, it is called whorled, as in Alstonia. Modifications of leaves. Leaves are often modified to perform functions other than photosynthesis. They are converted into tendrils for climbing, as in peas, or into spines for defense, as in cacti. The fleshy leaves of onion and garlic store food in some plant such as Australian acacia. The leaves are small and short-lived. The petioles in these plants expand, become green and synthesize food. Leaves of certain insectivorous plants such as pitcher plants, Venus fly, tape are also modified leaves. The inflorescence. A flower is a modified shoot wherein the shoot apical meristem changes to floral meristem. Internodes do not elongate and the axis gets condensed. The apex produces different kinds of floral appendages laterally at the successive nodes instead of leaves. When a shoot tip transforms into a flower, it is always solitary. The arrangement of flowers on the floral axis is termed as inflorescence. Depending on whether the apex gets converted into a flower or continues to grow, two major types of inflorescence are defined, racemose and cymose. In racemose type of inflorescence, the main axis continues to grow. The flowers are borne laterally in an acropetal succession. In cymose type of inflorescence, the main axis terminates in a flower, hence is limited in growth. The flowers are borne in a basipetal order. The flower. The flower is the reproductive unit in the angiosperms. It is meant for asexual reproduction. A typical flower has four different kinds of whorls arranged successively on the swollen end of the stalk or pedicel called thalamus or receptacle. These are calyx, corolla, androecium and gynoecium. Calyx and corolla are accessory organs while androecium and gynoecium are reproductive organs. In some flowers like lily, the calyx and corolla are not distinct and are termed as perianth. When a flower has both androecium and gynoecium, it is a bisexual. A flower having either only stamens or only carpels is unisexual. In symmetry, the flowers may be actinomorphic radial symmetry or zygomorphic bilateral symmetry. When a flower can be divided into two equal radial halves in any radial plane passing through the center, it is said to be actinomorphic. For example, mustard, datura, chili. When it can be divided into two similar halves only in one particular vertical plane, it is zygomorphic. As in pea, gulmohar, bean, cassia. A flower is asymmetric, irregular if it cannot be divided into two similar halves by any vertical plane passing through the center, as in canna. A flower may be trimerous, tetramerous or pentamerous when the floral appendages are in multiple 3, 4 or 5 respectively. Flowers with bracts reduced leaf found at the base of the pedicel are called bracteate and those without bracts ebracteate. Based on the position of calyx, corolla and androecium is respect of the ovary on thalamus, the flowers are described as hypogynous, perigynous and epigynous. In the hypogynous flower, the gynoecium occupies the highest position while the other then are situated below it. The ovary in such flowers is said to be superior, for example mustard, China rose and brinjal. If gynoecium is situated in the center and other parts of the flowers are located on the rim of the thalamus almost at the same level, it is called perigynous. The ovary here is said to be half inferior, for example plum, rose, peach. In epigynous flowers, the margins of the thalamus grows upward enclosing the ovary completely and getting fused with it. The other parts of flowers arise above the ovary, hence the ovary is said to be inferior. As in flowers of guava and cucumber and the ray florets of sunflowers. Now, parts of a flower. Each flower normally has four floral whorls: calyx, corolla, androecium and gynoecium. Calyx. The calyx is the outermost whorl of the flower and the members are called sepals. Generally, sepals are green, leaf-like and protect the flower in the bud stage. The calyx may be gamosepalous, sepals united or polysepalous, sepals free. Corolla. Corolla is composed of petals. Petals are usually brightly colored to attract insects for pollination like calyx. Corolla may be also free, gamopetalous or united polypetalous. The shape and color of corolla vary greatly in plants. Corolla may be tubular, bell-shaped, funnel-shaped or wheel-shaped. Aestivation. The mode of arrangement of sepals or petals in floral bud with respect to the other members of the same whorl is known as aestivation. The main types of aestivation are valvic, twisted, imbricate and maxillary. When sepals or petals in a whorl just touch one another at the margin without overlapping as in calotropis, it is said to be valvate. If one margin of the appendages overlaps that of the next one and so on, as in China rose, lettuce finger and cotton. It is called twisted. If the margins of sepals or petals overlap one another but not in any particular direction, as in cassia and gulmohar. The aestivation is called imbricate. In pea and bean flowers there are 5 petals. The largest standard overlaps the 2 lateral petals, which in turn overlap the 2 smallest anterior petals scale. This type of aestivation is known as vexillary or papilionous. Androecium. Androecium is composed of stamen. Each stamen, which represents the male reproductive organ, consists of a stalk or a filament and an anther. Each anther is usually bilobed and each lobe has 2 chambers. The pollen sacs, the pollen grains are produced in pollen sacs. A sterile stamen is called staminode. Stamens of flower may be united with other members such as petals or among themselves. When stamens are attached to the petals, they are epipetalous as in brinjal, or epiphyllous when attached to the perianth as in the flowers of lily. The stamens in the flowers may either remain free polyandrous or may be united in varying degrees. The stamens may be united into one bunch or one bundle, monoadelphous as in China rose, or 2 bundles, diadelphous as in pea, or into more than 2 bundles, polyadelphous as in citrus. There may be variation in the length of filaments within flowers as in salvia and mustard. Gynoecium. Gynoecium is the female reproductive parts of the flower and is made up of one or more carpels. A carpel consisting of 3 parts, namely stigma, style and ovary. Ovary is the enlarged basal part on which lies the elongated tube. The style connects the ovary to the stigma. The stigma is usually at the tip of the style and is the receptive surface for pollen grains. Each ovary bears one or more ovules attached to the flattened cushion-like placenta. When more than one carpel is present, they may be free, as in lotus and rose are called apocarpus. They are termed as when more than one carpel is present, they may be free, as in lotus and rose and are called apocarpus. They are termed syncarpus. When carpels are fused, as in mustard and tomato, after fertilization the ovules develop into seeds and the ovary matures into a fruits. Placentation. The arrangement of ovules within the ovary is known as placentation. The placentation are of different types, namely marginal, axile, parietal, basal, central and free central. In marginal placentation, the placenta forms a ridge along the ventral suture of the ovary and the ovules are borne on this ridge, forming 2 rows as in pea. When the placenta is axile and the ovules are attached to it in a multilocular ovary, the placentation is said to be axile, as in China rose, tomato and lemon. In parietal placentation, the ovules develop on the inner wall of the ovary or on peripheral parts. Ovary is 1 chambered, but it becomes 2 chambered due to the formation of the false septums, for example mustard and argemone. When the ovules are borne on central axis, in our septa are absent, as in dianthus and primrose, the placentation is called free central. In basal placentation, the placenta develops at the base of ovary and a single ovule is attached to it, as in sunflower, marigold. The fruit is a characteristic features of the flowering plants. It is mature or ripe ovary developed after fertilization. If a fruit is formed without fertilization of the ovary, it is called a parthenocarpic fruit. Generally, the fruit consists of a wall or pericarp and seeds. The pericarp may be dry or fleshy. When pericarp is thick and fleshy, it is differentiated into the outer epicarp, the middle mesocarp and the inner endocarp. In mango and coconut, the fruit is known as drupe. They develop from monocarpellary superior ovaries and are one-seeded. In mango, the pericarp is well differentiated into an outer thin epicarp, a middle fleshy edible mesocarp and an inner stony hard endocarp. In coconut, which is also a drupe, the mesocarp is fibrous. The seed
The ovules after fertilization develops into seeds. A seed is made up of a seed coat and an embryo. The embryo is made up of a radical and embryonal axis and one as in wheat, maize or two cotyledons as in gram and pea. Structures of dicotyledonous seeds. The outermost covering of a seed is the seed coat. The seed coat has two layers, the outer testa and the inner tegument. The hilum is a scar on the seed coat through which the developing seeds were attached to the fruit. Above the hilum is a small pore called the microphylle. Within the seed coat is the embryo consisting of an embryonal axis and two cotyledons. The cotyledons are often fleshy and full of reserve food materials. At the two ends of the embryonal axis are present the radical and the plumule. In some seeds, such as castor, the endosperm formed as a result of double fertilization is a food storing tissue. In plants, such as bean, gram, and pea, the endosperm is not present in mature seeds, and such seeds are called non-endospermous. A structure of monocotyledonous seeds. Generally, monocotyledonous seeds are endospermic, but some, as in orchids, are non-endospermic. In the seeds of cereals, such as maize, the seed coat is membranous and generally fused with the fruit wall. The endosperm is bulky and stores food. The outer covering of endosperm separates the embryo by a proteinaceous layer called aleurone layer. The embryo is small and situated in a groove at one end of the endosperm. It consists of one large and shield-shaped cotyledon known as scutellum and a short axis with a plumule and a radical. The plumule and radical are enclosed in sheaths which are called sulloptile and coleoriza respectively. Semi-technical description of a typical flowering plant. Various morphological features are used to describe flowering plants. The description has to be brief in a simple and scientific language and presented in proper sequence. The plant is described beginning with its habit, vegetative character, roots, stem and leaves, and then floral characters in flower scene and flower parts. After describing various parts of plants, a floral diagram and a floral formula are presented. The floral formula is represented by some symbol. In the floral formula, BR stands for bracteate, capital K stands for calyx, and C for corolla, P for perianth, A for androecium, and capital G for gynoecium. G for superior ovary and upper bar of G for inferior ovary. Male sign, female sign for bisexual plants, plus sign in a circle for actinomorphic, and the percent for zygomorphic nature of flower. Fusion is indicated by enclosing the figure within bracket and adhesion by a line row. Above the symbols of the floral parts, a floral diagram provides information about the number of parts of flower, their arrangements and the relation they have with one another. The position of the mother axis with respect to flower is represented by a dot on the top of the floral diagram. Calyx, corolla, androecium and gynoecium are drawn in successive whorls. Calyx begin the outermost and the gynoecium begin in the center. Floral formula also shows cohesion and adhesion within parts of whorls and in between whorls. The floral diagrams and floral formula represents the mustard plants family Brassicaceae. The description of some important families you can see and read in the NCERT.